Hi, I'm Guillaume Meyer. I'm a technical artist at Adobe Substance 3D. And today I would like to present the new Substance integration available inside Cinema 4D 2020 4.3. Motion design projects frequently use Cinema 4D and the Substance 3D toolset together, as Substance materials offer a convenient way to texture your asset within Cinema 4D by using the Substance integration. Substance 3D materials are high quality and versatile, allowing you to customize them for any scene directly in Cinema 4D. Okay, let's jump in Cinema 4D to take a look. First, you don't need to install any Substance add-on because the Substance integration is native in C4D. Also, the new integration no longer uses the Substance Asset Manager from the Extension tab. However, it will be kept for legacy workflows. Make sure that Redshift 3.5.24 or later is set as the renderer for your project. To begin, open the Asset Browser to find the Substance 3D group under the Materials section. Click on it to get access to a selection of 40 Substance materials included with Cinema 4D. These assets are SBSAR files. SBSAR are dynamic materials with parameters that output maps for 3D renderers like Redshift. Open the Material Manager and drag and drop any of these materials in it. A Redshift material is created on the fly with the SBSAR linked to it. Let's assign the material to assets in our scene. If you want to adjust the material, click once on its thumbnail, then go into the Attribute panel to tweak the parameters. You can increase its default resolution to 2K. You'll find also generic parameters like color or specific ones like fingerprints density. I will pick a color from this color palette downloaded from Adobe Color, which is a web platform to explore and build color palettes for your projects. You can also import SBSAR files from your desktop. SBSAR can be downloaded through the Substance 3D Asset Library or created within Substance 3D Designer or Sampler. Let's download one SBSAR from the Substance 3D Asset website. Then drag and drop all the SBSAR from the folder to the Material Manager. Cinema 4D will automatically convert them into Redshift standard materials. Okay. If you textured some asset with Substance 3D Painter, exporting the map as SBSAR files will speed up the conversion process in Cinema 4D. In the export window, select the SBSAR and the Redshift RS material template and click on export. Once exported, drag and drop the SBSAR into the Material Manager to convert them to Redshift standard materials. Again, let's assign these materials. Now that we've seen the different import workflows in Cinema 4D, let's deep dive into the node editor to check what's happening under the hood. If you double-click on the material thumbnail, Cinema 4D will open the node editor. On the left, you can see the Substance 3D material node with its texturing outputs. Cinema 4D automatically linked the outputs from the SBSAR to the inputs of the Redshift standard material. The autolink works for classic PBR maps like base color, roughness, metallic, normal, and height, but also for the subsurface, sheen, anisotropy, emissive, and coat maps. If you are curious about the usages naming convention Cinema 4D uses to make the autolink, here's the complete list of the output usages to be set in Substance Designer. Substance Sampler and Substance Painter will automatically name these output usages in your SBSAR at the export. For the modeling clay, the PBR maps with the translucency, scattering color, and scattering distance scale maps are plugged correctly in the Redshift material. If you updated your SBSAR after the import in Cinema 4D, you can reload it with the Reload button. In the node editor, you can combine the Substance node with other Redshift nodes. To do so, add a color correct node and place it on the base color link. Then you can shift the U parameter. Also, you can drive any of the substance parameters with a value or a color node by linking it to the back of the node. This will allow you to drive multiple parameters with the same value. If you want to compute the displacement on your material, Cinema 4D already plugged the height from the SBSAR to the displacement in the node editor. The last step to make it work is to add a RS object tag on your model. Then select Geometry, click on Override, and enable displacement and the tessellation if needed. The maximum displacement and the displacement scale parameters are in centimeters. you can input the same height value in centimeter for both inputs. For materials, in the asset browser, you'll find the physical size value by right-clicking on it and selecting Show Details. For materials downloaded from the Substance 3D Asset Library, you'll find the physical size on the website under the technical information when the asset is selected. Also, when the auto bump is enabled on the RS object tag, don't forget to unplug the bump map from the Redshift standard material. If not, the material surface detail will be combined and look too intense. Before we conclude, I would like to show one last thing about Substance 3D materials. SBSAR parameters can be animated through the timeline. If you click on the keyframe icon next to the slider, it will set their value on the timeline. When pressing play, the SBSAR will recompute at each frame and you'll get animated textures. The computation time for the SBSAR may vary depending on its resolution. For a quick animation test, you can lower the resolution to get fast feedback, and increase the resolution at the end for the final renders. Okay, in this video we've seen many interesting workflows. What I enjoyed the most about the new Substance integration in Cinema 4D is the fast import workflow, which eliminates tedious hours spent on material mapping. Adding Substance 3D to the mix provides an incredible solution to get realistic and lifeful materials to your renders. I hope you enjoyed it too. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more tutorial videos.